morning class. Today we are going to learn about very different type of water treatment, that is known as your effluent treatment systems. Let us see what does it mean and what does it hold. So effluent treatment plant covers the mechanisms and processes used to treat such waters that have been contaminated in some way by orthopathogenic industrial or commercial activities prior to its release into the environment or its reuse. Dear students, it means that whatever contaminated or whatever unhealthy water is coming from the industries, from any of the factories which are in the MIDC areas, so those water has to be collected and then they have to be done such a treatment that it is recycled and again it is reused. So this type of water is collected and that treatment is known as effluent treatment plant. The effluent contains several pollutants which can be removed with the help of an effluent treatment plant. EPT treats water and makes free from all objectionable impurities present in suspension, colloidal or dissolved form. So, what is effluent treatment plant? What does it contain? Let us see in brief. Effluent treatment plant is a process designed for treating the industrial waste water for its reuse or safe disposal to the environment. So first it includes effluent. It means untreated industrial water. Then effluent is in treated industrial wastewater, and sludge, solid part separated from water, wastewater by ETP. So this is what is done. First, the untreated industrial water is collected and then the treatment is done, and when treatment is done, the treated water is separated from the remaining sludge. Sludge is the waste material which is collected, and the treated water is then again transmitted to the areas where water is needed. So this is the flow diagram. The effluent untreated water, then the treatment is done, and then the sludge is collected and the treated water is then again distributed. So why do we need to treat effluent? So there are many points. A few points are there to prevent groundwater pollution. Yes, whenever we are having the untreated waste material from the industries, if we just flow it on the soil, then what will happen? It will try to penetrate into the soil and then it will reach the groundwater. And groundwater is rich in minerals and the chemicals which are good for mankind. And if we just flow the untreated water there, then what will happen? That groundwater will be contaminated and our wells and rivers from where we get the water will be affected. So we need to treat this water. Then to prevent the seashore, so that is the second point. If we just leave the water in the rivers or the seas, then they will be contaminated and the living things inside that may be affected. So we cannot do that also. So we have to treat that water. Then to prevent the soil, of course, if we just lead the water into the soil will be contaminated and corroded and it can lead to different airs. To prevent marine life, yes, we cannot live in the rivers and seashores, since the living organisms are there, we have to prevent their lives, so we cannot just leave the water in that. Protection of the public health, to reuse the treated effluent for agriculture, for groundwater recharge, for industrial recycle, solving social problems caused by the accumulation of wastewater. So this is the flow chart for ETP. So first, if you can see, the wastewater effluent is collected in the primary treatment, then primary clarifier flocculator is used, and then the surge is collected from here also, and the water is passed in the aeration tank. Then aeration tank, it is given to secondary clarifier, then from secondary clarifier again it is transferred to disinfection section, and then to the final effluent. From here all the sludge is collected, and the collected sludge is treated and disposed very easily. Hello?
Hello, तुला जेवायला आणून देऊ का मम्मा?
नाही थांब, मी क्लास घेते.
किती वेळ भूके राहशील का?
नाही, मी भाजी पोळी खाल्ली आहे ना. मी फोन
करते. भाजी पोळी.
अच्छा, आणून आणून ठेवून दे. मी नंतर.
आवाज अटकतोय.
आणून ठेवून दे आणि लसणाची कळी आणून देशील. तू जेवून घे मग. सो द मेजर ट्रीटमेंट युनिट्स इन ईटीपी आर प्राइमरी ट्रीटमेंट. इन दैट स्क्रीन्स आर देयर. द स्क्रीन्स डू नॉट अलाउ द अनवॉन्टेड स्लज मटेरियल एंटर into the treatment plant. Then detritor and scrappers, which just take out the colloidal particles or floating materials. Grit chamber, skimming tanks and aeration, these are the areas where the water is treated and made useful. Then from primary treatment it is going to the secondary treatment and sedimentation and settlement tank. Thus water is settled down there, sand sedimentation is done. Then clarifloculator is there, coagulant is used and the flocks are formed, and then the colloidal particles settle down. Then equalizer tank and neutralization tanks are there, which makes the water free from all odors and smell. Then there is a tertiary and secondary treatment, activated sludge process, then trickling filter, then aerated lagoons, multiple evaporator plant, rotating biological contactors. All these equipments are used to treat the water which is contaminated and making it pure. Then sand membrane filters, sand filters are used which make the contaminated water clear. Activated carbon filters are there, disinfection, ion exchange, nutrient removal. So all these things makes the water purify and useful. So next is your solid waste management. What is solid waste actually? So waste, what is waste? So substances or objects which are disposed of or are intended to be disposed of or are required to be disposed of by the provisions of the law is called as waste. Anything which is not useful, which is a waste, which is we are just throwing it off, is a waste, whether it is in a solid form or a liquid form. We need to dispose it very quickly and cleverly so that the human mankind is not affected. So what does the disposal means? Any operation which may lead to resource recovery, recycling, reclamation, direct reuse or alternate uses. So all these things are known as disposal means. So what is the solid waste? It is defined as non-liquid, non-soluble materials ranging from municipal garbage to industrial waste that contain complex and sometimes hazardous substances. See students, if they are from industries and they are chemical and food industries, then there are lot many non-disposable waste are there, solid waste, and we have to make it very very good arrangement to dispose of, because they may be sometime toxic or poisonous for human health. So solid waste includes garbage, rubbish, demolition products, sewage treatment residue, dead animals, manure and other discarded materials. So solid waste in India, 7.2 million tons of hazardous waste, 1 square kilometer of additional landfill area every year, rupees 1600 crore for treatment and disposal of hazardous waste. In addition to the industrial discharge, about 150 million tons of high volume, low hazard waste every year, which is mostly dumped on open low lying areas. So what collection in India? Primary by the city municipality, no gradation of waste product. For example, biodegradable glasses, poly bags, paper shreds, etc. dumps these waste to the city outskirts. And second is local raddiwala, kabadiwala, rag pickers, collecting small iron pieces by magnets, collecting glass bottles, collecting paper for recycling. Disposal of solid waste, sanitary landfilling, shredding, composting, incineration, barging it out into the sea. So this is how we need to dispose. So waste management concept, there is reduce, reuse and recycle. So these three are very significantly used. So the three R's, reduce, reuse, recycle, to be followed for waste management. So what is reduce? Disposable goods, paper plate, paper bowl, styrofoam cup, plastic spoon, roll of paper, towels, paper napkin, durable goods, ceramic, plastic plate, metal spoon, glass, plastic drinking cup, dish towel, cloth napkin, and many more. These are very few things which I have written here. So all these are the disposable things. Recovery of 1 ton paper can be saved 17 trees. So papers are also to be saved, not wasted. So reuse, instead of buying new containers from the market, use the ones that are in the house. Don't throw away the soft drink cans or paint on them and use as pencil stands or small vases. So we all do that in our childhood. We have already done this, and again also you can use this for some other purposes also. So recycling, reduce environmental degradation, making money out of waste, save energy that would have gone into waste handling and product manufacture. Making paper from waste saves 50% energy. Every ton of recycled glass saves energy equivalent to 100 liters of oil. See how many things we can do from recycling. Dear students, it is very very necessary that whatever we are using, think of it how it can be recycled. okay? So recycling is very, very good to save the nature, to save the environment. Then stability in construction. Sustainability is defined as meeting the needs of present generations without compromising the ability of future generations to meet their needs. Okay, sustainability means green buildings, green environment to keep the structure cool and calm. So sustainable building or green buildings refers to the structure which are both environmentally responsible and resource efficient through a building's life cycle. Sustainable building design involves balance between home building and sustainable environment. So dear students, there are three logical parts which we have to take care in sustainable construction. So first is technological factors, managerial factors and social factors. All three, then when it combines, a sustainable construction can take place. So provide comprehensive method of measuring and monitoring environmental performance. Consider all areas of sustainability, economic, environment and social. So it is very, very important that we should know how much capital, how much money we are having. What will be the environmental effects if we have this green building into the construction? And what will be the social aspects? What will be the social areas which we can cover while doing this sustainable building construction? So these all points we should keep into mind and then design any building. New homes only make up to 2% of the national housing stock. So the main challenge is to improve the mass of older houses. New homes present as easy opportunity to build with minimal environment impact and maximum health benefit. You are aware of the new constructions. They all are having the local environment. They are having gyms, gas pipelines, water headed systems. Garden is there in the new commercial constructions. And the terrace gardens are also sometimes provided to keep the building green, cool and calm. So this is how the new construction is having the maximum benefit to the mankind. So these are the types of sustainable materials: wool, brick, sustainable concrete, solar tiles, paper insulation. It reduces so much of the heat that you can see that whenever you are having any type of design on the building, the papers are almost used maximum times, newspapers, and they are used for insulation. They can just keep your walls cool and calm during the summer season, and in winter and rainy season it can just keep away the water pollutants outside. Then triple glazed window, it keeps the building very, very cool in the summers and dry in winter and rainy seasons. Merits and demerits of sustainable construction. Merits: efficient technologies, easier maintenance, improved indoor air quality, energy and water efficient. Demerits: initial cost is high, availability of materials, need more time for construction, need more skilled labors. So thank you so much for today. In the next class, we will see the third part of unit number 2. And quickly we'll cover the unit number 2 and run for unit number 3. Thank you so much for today.